Good afternoon from the breezy Stadio Comunale here in the city of Iesi, where Italy and Wales kick off their 2017 Six Nations campaign, some 10 kilometres from the Adriatic coast at Ancona. A good crowd here in anticipation of what promises to be an entertaining clash between two experienced teams as they line up for the anthems. Wales arriving on the back of a confidence-boosting away win over Ireland in a warm-up match 2 weeks ago, and knowing that the Italians are a tough nut to crack on home turf. The teams line up then for the formalities of the national anthems and the accompaniment provided by the band of the Bersaglieri, the local military band, who add a little bit of colour to the proceedings. Well, it's good to see and hear the Welsh women taking the initiative here against the accompaniment of a somewhat funereal band of the Bersaglieri, not quite in tune with the Welsh national anthem, but wait for Fratelli d'Italia, a call to arms.
Fratelli d'Italia, l'Italia sedesta dell'elmo di Scipio, se città la testa dove la vittoria le porga la chioma che schiava di Fratelli d'Italia, Italia sedesta dell'elmo di Scipio, se cinta la testa, dov'è la vittoria, ne porga la chioma, che schiava di Roma, il Dio la creò. Trigiancia corte, sia pronti alla morte, pronti alla morte, l'Italia chiamò. Stringiamoci a corte, sia pronti alla morte, sia pronti alla morte, l'Italia chiamò, sì!
The rousing chorus of Fratelli d'Italia, as one would expect here in the city of Iesi and in the Stadio Comunale Pacifico Carotti. As we look ahead then to the opening encounter between Italy and Wales, and the teams, well, Italy pretty much a well-established squad with no less than 11 players returning from last season, including scrum half and captain Sara Baratin. She's the glue that holds their side together, and alongside her is Beatrice Ragoni, whose two tries in the corresponding fixture 12 months ago put pay to Welsh ambitions. Up front, the tireless hooker Melissa Bettoni, who started a tight head 12 months ago, will have the forwards fired up for this one. Wales also have game breakers in former captain Rachel Taylor and fellow back rower Seanette Harris, who crossed the try line twice against Italy in 2016. Captain Caris Phillips is flanked by hard-working Caryl Thomas and Amy Evans in the front row, whilst young Kira Bevan and veteran campaigner Ellie Snowsill at halfback will look to get the ball wide early and look out for fullback Dyddgu Hywel, a dangerous counter-attacker in broken play. So the stage is set then, and the replacements. Some familiar names on the Welsh side. Laurie Harris returns, and Jess Kavanagh-Williams is looking for her first cap. Arighetti, Folli and Magatti are also seasoned campaigners for Italy. Our referee for this match is from Canada, Rose Labrecht, and there is very much an international flavour to the officiating team here, with Zwindile Jadisveni on one touchline and local Italian referee Clara Munarini on the other. So it'll be Italy to kick off in their opening match into a stiff breeze in this opening 40 minutes. And Wales, well, they've found it hard to win games away from home in the recent past, but under coach Roland Phillips, they've scored two good wins against Spain and against Ireland at Donnybrook a fortnight ago, which means that they arrive here on the Adriatic coast in good heart. Kira Bevan with her first touch of the ball. Ball didn't go forward, says Rose Labrecht, or did it? Yes, it did. So waiting for advantage to Italy, and we'll have our first scrum of the game. Rose Labrecht, the only Canadian official at the 2016 Olympic Games in Rio, comes here with a great deal of experience, a former player herself. Wales have a distinct advantage in the scrum.
Let's,
here,
let's just take a step, ladies.
Pretty spongy underfoot following a heavy downpour overnight. So it's long sprigs, long spikes all round. The pitch is a little narrower than one you'd expect, primarily because it is a dedicated stadium, a soccer stadium after all. And the teams might find space at a premium in the wider channels. As they look to spread it wide, as indeed do the Italians early on here, looking to bring in the centre pairing of Paola Zangirolani and Maria Cioffi. Wales on the defensive, that is Zangirolani with the red headgear. Sara Baratin, the captain. Good pressure being applied here by Wales. The tackle comes in from Rachel Taylor, who captained Wales at the Women's Rugby World Cup in France in 2014. The ball held up by the breeze finds Ellen Evans, the speedster, looking for space in midfield. Ankle tapped on halfway, but it's there for Bevan to Snowsill. On to number eight, Shauna Powell-Hughes. Usually starts at lock forward, does Powell-Hughes. Interesting selection from Roland Phillips. He's chosen Powell Hughes at number eight, with Seanette Harris on the flank today. Interesting to see how that goes.
Yep. Time off, guys. Just going to deal with the blood sub first.
So a blood injury will need some attention to one of the Italian backs. Looks as if it could be Maria Cioffi.
Okay, okay, just kidding.
From the Rugby Colorno club.
Caris
Phillips,
the
Welsh captain.
We're not, time's not on.
Makes no difference that she is the daughter of the Wales coach, Roland Phillips. But he is the coach after all, and I'm just another player, she says. Good atmosphere in the Welsh camp this morning in the hotel, and interestingly both teams stayed at the same hotel, which is unusual. So let's see what Wales do here. Shortened line-out, the first line-out of the game.
Time is in.
Right at the back is Caryl Thomas waiting to propel Rachel Taylor into the air. There she goes. Bevan onto Snowsill, can't take it. Off the foot, says referee Labrech, as Bevan marshals her troops on the narrow side there, taken up by prop forward Amy Evans. Captain Phillips just about manages to hold on to possession. In comes fullback Dyddgu Hywel, just in case she's needed. First touch of the ball, then out wide to AD Taverner, steps out of the tackle, taken by prop forward Lucia Gai. Italy have a solid defence. That's a big hit coming in from Flavia Severin. More of her later as Wales put the kick through. First test then for Elisa Giordano. Doesn't find touch. Snowsill gathers inside her own half, releases Dyddgu Hywel, and this is where she's at her best. The little kick into the wide open spaces. Will the bounce be kind for the Wales fullback? Good harassing there by her. It's all hands to the pump here from Italy inside their own 22. As Wales set up the defence right across the field. Severin goes to ground. European boxing champion, a flanker, but today playing at lock forward for Italy. So good pressure being applied by Wales. Snowsill with the hand clap there, cheering on her forwards. Good work, she says.
Make your own space.
This is where Wales want to be playing their rugby, in the Italian half and in the Italian 22, and they need to take advantage of the stiff breeze in this first half. It's blowing diagonally across the field from the far side, so they need to get points on the board. To the back it goes again, a little clumsily nudged forward. It's a bit of a lottery, isn't it, to throw into the back in this weather, but the hand came in there from Alicia Giordano, the Italian number 8.
Sorry guys, bring it up, just get a bit closer, okay, so that we're temple to temple. Crouch! Bind! Set!
Sara Baratin, the captain, so much revolves around her. Picked up by Giordano. Again, it's a loose pass. In from right wing is Michaela Silari. Straight into the hands there of AD Taverner. Well experienced campaigner for Wales is AD Taverner. She was a fullback against Italy in the 2016 Six Nations campaign. Well taken around the bootstraps there somewhere. Caryl Thomas, doughty campaigner for Wales. And Italy have done well.
Blue moving forward.
Came in from behind the gate. Perfectly legitimate going forward. They'll get the put in. Much to the delight of the Italian bench. Good effort here. There's Giordano again coming through. Maybe the lock forward, actually. Alice Trevisan. From the Rugby Riviera Club, 34 caps to her name. Played in all five games in the 2016 Six Nations. Wales looking to use that weight advantage to good effect, and they should get a penalty here. Excellent work of the scrum. Well drilled there by Paul Young. Assistant to Roland Phillips in the Welsh camp.
Can I have
they will
right
be absolutely
here?
Delighted in the front row. Caryl Thomas, Caris Phillips and Amy Evans.
Yeah, yeah, that's fine.
So it'll be Elinor Snowsill to take this kick, talented outside half. He's made rapid progress, having only taken up the game in her late teens. There's the distance. We should be only too aware of the strength of the wind behind her. Left footed. Some 25 metres out from goal. 8 minutes on the clock. Steady in concentration. Snowsill steps up, left footed. And puts it away for the opening score. Then Wales opened their campaign in the 2017 Six Nations with a well-struck penalty goal from their outside half, Elinor Snowsill, and Wales lead Italy after some 8 minutes of play, courtesy of this powerful scrimmage and an accurate kick from Snowsill, 3-0. It's Women's Rugby World Cup here, of course, and both these teams will look for a good campaign in the Six Nations to set them on the way. World Cup in Ireland in August. Dyddgu Hywel gets good distance, but only finds Manuela Furlan, the Italian fullback, who, along with Michaela Silari here, play their rugby for the Aylesford Bulls Ladies Rugby Club in London, England. Will is back there. She's got support from Ellen Evans, should she be required. And again, her first instinct is to counter. Giving chase. Where's that going to land?
Inside the 10 here.
An Italian player within 10 metres. So will Elinor Snowsill have another go here, or will she kick for territory? It's looking good for Wales early on. Good take there by Rachel Taylor. So Wales again back inside the Italian 22 as Phillips lines up this line out. Amy Evans stands at the front, and again it's Taylor at the back. Into the back it goes. Expertly taken once again, and the forwards get in there and drive forward. There's not much that the Italians can do to withhold the power of that Welsh forward eight. They did this to extremely good effect against Ireland to claim a rare victory against the Irish 2 weeks ago. 5 metres short then of the Italian try line. This is great stuff from Wales. Italians have gone to ground. The referee is waiting for an advantage. And surely there are bodies lying on the ground illegally.
Brought down by a red player.
Well.
Unplayable, brought down by a red player.
Unplayable.
Red brought it down. Scrum, blue, unplayable.
Caryl Phillips protests, shakes the head.
This is the scrum.
Wales won't worry unduly about having to go down to the scrum. They've shown their power already. Some trepidation on the faces of the Italian women, knowing that there's going to be a huge shove coming through here in the next few seconds. 11 minutes on the clock. Wales lead by 3.
Bring it up, guys. We're not going to have head on head here, okay? There's a clear space, and there's a clear space for you. Put your head in the space.
So won't have head on hand, says referee Lebrecht. Find the space, find the gap between the heads.
Bind! Bring it up, guys. Just patience, okay? Watch. Remember, wait.
Struggling, yeah?
So the pressure will come through on Lucia Guy in the tight end, Caryl Thomas. On the loose head. It's a better scrum from Italy. Baratin just about gets the ball away. And only as far as Dyddgu Hywel. Again, she sets off. Needs to turn here and lay back, as she does. Bevan waits. Eight. And Wales will get the penalty. Away goes Bevan. Now then, where's the support? She's run away from the supporting players. And Wales have to react very quickly. Out it comes into midfield. Robin Wilkins. Again, it's there this time for Taverner in from the left flank. 10 metres short on the Italian try line. Good quick ball. That's what was needed. This is Mel Clay, relative newcomer in the Welsh ranks, proving her worth once again. Wilkins floats it out wide to the hands of Taverner. Taverner cuts back inside, off the right foot, inside the 5 metres from the Italian try line. Phillips, the captain, head high into the tackle, but again does well, lays it back for Bevan. Snowsill, patience is what's required here. Seanette Harris, 2 tries against Italy at Aberavon 12 months ago. Wales coming off second best this time. Howell, lovely step off the left foot, brought to ground. Wales still pressing. Good tackle, big hits coming through. And the ball lost forward. That's so right. Great defensive effort there from Italy. It looked promising, didn't it, at one stage?
Mark's here, guys.
Again, as Dyddgu Hywel came back off the left foot. Sure, well, it did go forward though. So back we go once again, then into the scrum.
I wanted to feel you, yeah.
Incidentally, if you're watching in Wales, there'll be a documentary next Thursday or Friday in the scrum, following the efforts of the Welsh women of late, and that should be a very good watch.
Early blue. Early, I've asked you for patience, early engage.
Clear sign from referee Lebrecht. Early engage from Italy, so it's a technical offence. It's a short arm penalty, it's a free kick. Taken up by the forwards once again at the heart of the Italian defence. Bevan asks for some more bodies to take that ball further, ever closer to the Welsh try line. In goes Mel Clay, the Welsh number 5, out. Lovely work here to the try line. And if that ball has been touched down at the base of the uprights, then it's a try. Not yet, inches short. This time it's Caryl Thomas, and that is the first try. The referee's arm is in the air. Excellent work from that free kick. Well-drilled outfit, and this Welsh 8, well, they've got some power behind them when they do get going. Terrific start for Wales, but they need to rack up the points in this opening 40 minutes. The early engagement from Italy at the scrum then, and they were back on their heels. And over goes Caryl Thomas, the Welsh loose head prop forward, but a valuable try.
Shot my line here is good.
So Snowsill will line up the conversion. And it's worth recalling here that Wales have not defeated Italy since 2013. And that was won by a solitary point, 16-15. Well struck conversion again from Elinor Snowsill, and Wales are out to a 2-score advantage with 16 minutes on the clock. It's Italy 0, Wales 10. Caryl Thomas from the Bristol club and the Scarlets region in West Wales. And she made her debut actually against Italy way, way back in 2006. So she's been around for some 10 years as the veteran Wales prop. Smiles all round on the Wales bench. And suddenly the Italian supporters have found their voice as Thomas strides away downfield once again. Snowsill into the hands of the captain, Phillips. That's Wilkins to Kerin Lake from the Ospreys. Won't go far. It's well chased though by Seanette Harris. Drops though into the hands of Isabella Locatelli, the Italian number 7. Now then, let's see what the Italian loose head prop can do with ball in hand. That's Elisa Cucchiella. San Girolami kick downfield from Silari. A mistake from Dyddgu Hywel, a rare mistake from the Wales fullback. She'll put that behind her. Farmer's daughter from near Betws y Coed in North Wales. It's a good contingent of players from North Wales, not an area you'd associate with rugby usually, but the Carnarvon RFC is a stronghold for women's rugby in North Wales.
Patience, okay?
So, yeah. Pound die is here, so if you go to Carnarvon.
Straight, please.
Yes.
This is your therapist and analyst going about their duties in the Welsh camp.
Bind!
Okay.
Time off. Okay, where's the captain, please? Yeah. So I'll deal with the front row, okay? Just let them, don't ask her not to stand up and I'll deal with it if there's a problem, okay?
Italian captain does not speak English, so the interpreter there was Alice Trevisan, the lock forward, wearing five. And I was wondering, having seen, having noted that Flavia Severin, usually a flanker, has been promoted to the second row berth, not carrying that much weight. And that might hinder Italian prospects in the tight contest. Some good work again by Wales. And Snowsill will look to clear from inside her own 22. And takes play back into the Italian half.
Red line. There, get here.
Again, it goes to the back, and Rachel Taylor climbs unchallenged. Robin Wilkins, fly half 12 months ago, scored 26 points in the 2016 campaign. Finds herself at inside centre, but a very useful player to have outside in the Snowsill options, the kicking options. Furlan runs it back. Started all five games in the 2016 Six Nations at fullback. From Benetton Treviso formerly. Ball bounces into touch beneath us here in the commentary position. Some drops of rain appearing on the cameras there. It's been threatening all afternoon. A huge downpour last evening. And it's a bit soggy underfoot.
Yes,
got a glimpse there of the South African assistant referee, Chungile Jadesveni. He'll take charge of the game between the Italian women and Scotland in Cumbernauld next month. Taylor again. Useful source of possession for Wales at the back of the line-out. This is Sioned Harris. Very talented wing forward. But is Wales penalised this time? Rigoni rather steps up, doesn't find touch, but good harassing from the Italian number 11, Sofia Stefan. These rugby in France, in Brittany for the Rennes club, a mid-table club in the French Women's Championship. No fewer than four of the Italian squad play their rugby for the Rennes club. Dyddgu Hywel, left-footed, just about gets it away. Struck the edge of the boot, but it's safely into touch on the Wales 10-meter line.
People standing at the ruck, they need to be behind, okay?
Cautious word there to the Welsh captain. Players to be careful at the ruck area.
In front of it, okay? At the ruck.
Be mindful of where they stand.
Okay.
Melissa Bettoni, another representative of the Wren club, throws in. Rigoni, very dangerous player, as she proved 12 months ago. Two tries to her name to set Italy on their way. One of them, the second, a 90-meter interception, which put bait, as I say, to Welsh ambitions on that occasion. But Wales steal it, and that's a huge kick downfield. Bounce not kind for Manuela Furlan. Little show. Sets up next phase of play just outside the Italian 10-meter line. Rigoni. Taverner, well placed. Wheels want to run it this time. Snowsill gets it away to Wilkins. Italy up very quickly out of the defense, spotted by Mel Clay. Pegs them back. With a 10-meter territorial advantage. Snowsill not really sure what she wanted to do with that kick. She tried perhaps to catch the Italians napping. They have it through Captain Baratin out to Rigoni. From the Valsugana Rugby Club in Padua, the Italian champions. Cucchiella on halfway. Here's his turn to defend. And low with the tackle. Taverner wrestles the Italian player to ground. It's awkward ball, but it's Italian advantage. Wales not releasing the player. Taverner, the player penalised. So good attacking position here for Italy. Just outside the Wales 22 on the far side of the field. Eden Taverner. Plays for the Ospreys region. South Wales.
Yeah, we'll play
former
on, we'll
Wales
play
under
on.
20s captain. So Italy. Shorten the line out. Not the best of line outs. Surely, yes, it did go forward. So the set piece is proving somewhat of a lottery for the Italians. Can't really get momentum from areas where they're traditionally pretty good.
Straight, please. Okay. Thank you. Come a bit closer.
Devon feeds, the drive comes through from the Italians, but it's been held up by Wales.
Reset.
Referee Brech will call for a reset here.
I'm just going to take a step on the other side. Through the captain, please. On the 15, guys.
This can I talk to you? Can you tell her? She's binding on my shirt. This?
Yeah, so I'm just gonna stand here, I'll take a look.
Okay, thank you. Before we bind.
Some protestations from the Welsh forwards that a shirt was being pulled.
Quote. Bind. Set.
Great shot. Down the tunnel. A straight feed, that's a rarity these days. But great to see. As Wales has turned beyond the defensive. Fortunate there, nudged forward by an Italian hand. And every call being challenged by both teams here.
Have a look,
referee Lebrecht, well, she does have an assistant referee on the far side. Not hearing too much of her so far. Loud cheers from the grandstand on the far side.
Come in closer, please, Fred.
some 2,500 capacity, and it's filled to the brim, and that's great.
I need you closer, okay? So on this side, because it's on an angle.
The Six Nations have brought this fixture out to the Adriatic coast, south of Rimini, some 4 hours, three, 4 hours by train or by car from Rome.
Bind! Set!
Low scrummaging. At the back, it's Shona Powell Hughes looking to use that left hand to good effect.
That's out.
To stave off an Italian challenge. Dyddgu Hywel left footed towards the far touchline, doesn't gain much ground. But finds good touch, and the breeze seems to have
blue line.
Changed in the last few minutes. It seems to be favouring Italy all of a sudden. So 28 minutes played.
Number.
Just the one try. But Wales lead by 10 to nil. Taken by Celery at the back. Young lady they call the fly. Flavia. This is better. Paola Zangirolami. There's the headgear in the midfield. Defensive work there by Wales. The hooker, Melissa Bettoni, runs straight at Elinor Snowsill, the outside half. Rigoni finds space and again pushes Wales back deep inside their own 22. Melissa Clay, winning her sixth cap today for Wales, and like a colleague in the second row, Rebecca Rowe, and prop forward Amy Evans, they all came through the Welsh Rugby Union's talent identification programme held back in September 2014, I think it was. Quickly into midfield, that's Powell Hughes again, powering downfield, setting it up nicely, back into the safe hands of Snowsill. Won't find touch. Solari waits into the hands of Manuela Furlan. And Sofia Stefan wants to have a go here. This is much, much better. Zangirolami to Cioffi. On the Wales 22, Rigoni to the prop forward, Lucia Gai. Patient build-up from Italy as they look for their first score. Not sure that was the best idea that Sofia Stefan has had.
Turnover's good, leave it, red. Red one, leave it. No, roll it,
Italy have won it back. Good work of the breakdown.
Turnover's good.
The turnover is good, says Rose Lebrecht. Much to the delight of the Italian supporters.
Back, please.
Can't play the ball on the ground. And some stray boots flying in as well.
We'll chat after. Sorry, we'll chat after.
Oh, lovely hands there from Paola Zangirolami.
Points called.
68 caps today for the centre.
10. Can you just use your sock? Yeah, it's fine. Yeah.
It's important that Italy get some points on the board here. Ah, I've seen that before. Can't bear to look. Way up in the stand, the Italian coaching team led by Andrea Di Giandomenico. So the kick will be from Michela Silari. She sealed the deal against Wales in 2016 with a penalty late in the game. How's that looking? Looking good. So those are now the first points for Italy. In this year's campaign, greeted and lauded by the
there's a rocket, she's
Italian supporters in the grandstand on the far side of the three, so of the field. So after 32 minutes of play, it's Italy 3, Wales 10. Italy finished the 2016 campaign in fifth position, Wales fourth. Powell Hughes waits for the bounce, turns on her heels, isolated somewhat, she needs some help here. So 2-3 meters outside the Wales 22. Carried back inside, so Dyddgu Hywel can't kick directly for a touch. She spotted a gap, which has now been filled by Manuela Furlan. Not sure that was the best choice, best option for Dyddgu Hywel, because Italy are straight back into the hunt here on the narrow side, picked up there by the hooker, Melissa Bettoni, and again drilling into the corner. This is much, much better from it, the home side. So after that somewhat shaky start from the Italians, they're right back in it here, and if they could get a score before the break here, then it could be a very interesting second half. Again, it's Taylor at the back for Wales, Powell Hughes, and one can see now why Roland Phillips has selected Powell Hughes at number 8. Dyddgu Hywel does well under pressure. Again, it's a huge long kick downfield. Furlan will run it back though. Almost up to the Welsh 10 meter line. It's there for Sarah Berrettin. Once again, Wales are penalised on the ground. And they have to be careful here, because Rose Lebrecht, well, she comes from a sevens refereeing background, where they operate a zero tolerance policy at the breakdown. Italy qualified for the Women's Rugby World Cup in Ireland in August for the first time since 2002. So it's an important 6 or 7 months for the Italian squad in the run-up to the Women's Rugby World Cup. And Lisa Giordano seemed to be up in the air for a considerable amount of time, which has secured possession. Rigoni looks for the runners and finds Zangirolami. Italy looking for a try here. Good tackle, but the try is there surely for Italy. That's the score they were looking for. A well-taken try by Manuela Furlan, and Italy are right back in it with 5 minutes to go before the break. It all came, it all stemmed from that loose kick a few minutes ago from Dyddgu Hywel. Italy building again through the line-out, and Giordano up in the air, well supported. A good run from Berrettin. Furlan, despite the try-saving tackle by Wales initially on the wing three-quarter, Furlan following up, and this conversion attempt here to draw the scores level. Silari. Right-footed, well struck, just drops short, so Wales still have that two-point advantage, 4 minutes to the break, but Italy have struck back here, and Wales have some thinking to do here. Because in the close quarters, they've done well, but they've dropped off a little in the last few minutes. Well taken try from Manuela Furlan. Coached by Gary Street at Aylesford Bulls Ladies, in anything but name, the Harlequins Rugby Football Club Ladies team. Gary Street, of course, he led England to the World Cup, Women's Rugby World Cup in France in 2014. Powell Hughes. Wales need to get back on the horse here. Just under 3 minutes to go before the break. Twisting and turning out to the tackle is Seanad Harris from the Scarlets region in West Wales. Dyddgu Hywel, the North Walian. Thomas, Wales try scorer. Again, head down up to halfway. Bevan back to Snowsill, right footed. Plenty of time. And Furlan again loves to get involved as the Italian fullback. Snowsill. Evades the tackle, but was aided and abetted. Things not working out for Wales at the moment. Guilty of crossing in front of Snowsill was Kira Bevan, preventing the Italian player from getting at the Wales outside half. So crucial 2 minutes here for Wales in the run-up to the break. Leading by 2 points, 10-8. It looked so good for them early on, didn't it? And Caryl Thomas went over for the try. There she is with the black helmet there, right to the back of the line-out. Severin. Didn't have to jump for that one. San Girolami. The kick again to the wide open spaces, covered by Dyddgu Hywel, just about manages to get the kick away into touch on the Welsh 22. Italy have three home games in this year's Six Nations, and when they arrive in Ireland, they know that they'll be facing the USA, Spain, and reigning champions England in August. Ranked seventh when the Women's Rugby World Cup draw was made. Wales ranked 10th at the moment. Italy come into this tournament with no warm-up fixtures, unlike Wales, and their coach Roland Phillips can look back on four wins from four warm-up games against Scotland and the UK Armed Forces, Spain 39-0, and then that great win in Ireland a fortnight ago, 22-14, although they trailed by 14 points at one time. So the clock turns to red at the end of this first half. Up goes Mel Clay, driven forward. Shielded at the back by Wales captain Caris Phillips. And on they go towards that 10-meter line. It's been stopped. A charge, into midfield. That could have been dangerous for Wales. Zanjirolami got her hands on the ball. So we arrive at the break then, following an entertaining first half when Wales went ahead through Snowsill's penalty and then that try from Caryl Thomas. But Italy have found their mojo in the last few minutes. A penalty from Silari and a try from Furlan, the fullback, and they go into the break, trailing Wales by 10-8. Thank you. Welcome back to the Stadio Comunale Pacifico Carotti for the second half of the game between Italy and Wales. The opening match for these two teams in the 2017 Six Nations campaign. And as ever between these two teams, there isn't much to choose between them. And at the top of the second half, Wales hold on to a slender lead of 2 points. They lead by 10-8. And they've only won one game away from home since they defeated Italy in the 2013 campaign, and that was in 2015 against Scotland. Snowsill gets support from Shona Powell Hughes, the long striding Wales number eight. And the first penalty of the second half goes Wales's way. And the wind has died down somewhat from the first half. And if there is a breeze, it might well favour Wales in this second period. As the captain, Baratin, looks to get away, but well spotted by referee Lebrecht. So a good position here at the top of the second half for Wales to attack and build on that two-point advantage. It looked so good for them for the first half hour or so, but then Italy struck back and claimed a try of their own to make the second half very interesting indeed. Rachel Taylor again wins the ball at the back of the line out, and again it's that concerted drive from the Welsh eight. The ball shielded by hooker and captain Caris Phillips deep into the Italian 22. There is space on the narrow side as Sonnet Harris gets her hands on the ball. A lot of shouting and bawling as Wales look for forward traction, but again Italy have done well to hold up the Welsh drive and to get the put in at the scrum. That's Amy Evans, the tight head for Wales, a former weightlifter. Only been playing rugby for some 2.5 years. So what is the decision here? So last player down will be Shona Powell Hughes, the Wales number eight.
Bind.
In she goes.
Set.
Not for the first time. The scrum collapses in the heap.
Just reset, guys.
And again, Rose Lebrecht will have a quick word.
Try binds, please, on this side.
Remember the free kick, girls, yeah?
Caryl Thomas on the far side. And the Wales has tried.
Same again, please, Kat. Yeah. Seconds. Come on, hit. Hold away.
Crouch. Bind.
Party, yeah, party.
Set.
Hit, two, three, four.
Long arm bind from the prop forwards. Wales look to turn Italy towards the narrow side and to get a penalty perhaps or possession advantage. Actually, Lebrecht was about to blow the whistle, but somehow Italy have managed to secure possession and get it away into touch on the just beyond the 22 meter line. Beatrice Rigoni. The Italian outside half played the first three games last season at inside centre, moved to fly half for Ireland and Wales, against whom she crossed the two first half tries. So Wales cut the line out to five. Taylor.
Four.
Prime source of possession at the line out for Wales. So they need to make good use of it here.
Number? Side.
Italy have done well initially.
Number eight.
But it was Italian number eight, Elisa Giordano, penalised by referee Lebrecht. Snowsill just drops it into touch now. Good position here, 5 metres out.
Let's be vigilant here.
Look for the Italian number eight.
Blue.
She is, last player up on her feet. Need a score here. Taylor does well again. Two-handed catch. Again, it's the drive. And listen to Taylor The former captain shouting the odds here, bawling the odds and willing the players towards that Italian try line. Again, held up short initially. And again, the Italians have got their act together here.
Advantage, offside.
So Wales will get the advantage for offside. They want more than 3 points.
Step.
Phillips, the captain, the short pop pass. Amy Evans is there,
still
lending her weight
offside
to the Welsh effort. Wales camped here on the Italian try line. Huge gap on the far side, but every Welsh player is over on the open side. As Clay, the lock forward, takes it to ground. This time, surely, Snowsill. Wilkins out to Dyddgu Hywel, steps off her left foot, and over she goes. A well-taken try from the Wales fullback. But it all came from that concerted forward effort. The move looked to have broken down when Snowsill found Wilkins in midfield, but she was able to get the pass away to Dyddgu Hywel. And that's a well-taken try by the Wales fullback in wide open territory. She had a lot of work to do, mind, to get to the try line. And that's a very important score for Wales at the top of the second half, which increases their lead to 7 points with the conversion to come. Roland Phillips, who coached out here in Italy for a period of some 4 years with Viadana and latterly with Ironi, speaks Italian with a Welsh accent. But he does speak Italian fluently, in fairness. Snowsill, left-footed. And just drops off the far upright. And the score remains then at 15 points to 8 in Wales's favour. And it took a sidestep from Dyddgu Hywel to take her to the try line. Woman looked to have broken down there. Italy, the fullback Furlan, had committed herself. Created an opening out wide. Now can Wales go on to win from here? That was the impetus they needed at the top of the second half. Powell Hughes, Wales full of running, and in particular Dyddgu Hywel. Good work from Rebecca Rowe.
Step.
The tall lock forward player who plays with the Furlan and Silari for the Aylesford Ladies Rugby Club in London. Will again approve fullback to Caryl Phillips, to Powell Hughes. Hughes a weight, that's a brilliant handoff of the Italian 13, Maria Cioffi, and she knew all about that handoff. Taverner. And Wales have come out for the second half full of purpose.
Straight over, you have to keep her feet, please.
Cioffi going off her feet, not supporting her body weight. And a chance for Snowsill to clear downfield. Right footed this time. Not the longest of kicks, but it's safe into touch.
Time off. Captain. Keep the ball down, please. Yeah.
Captain here.
Just have a word, okay? I'm not going to have your players yelling at me every breakdown, okay? I'll referee the game, they'll play. Have a word.
A little exuberance perhaps from the Welsh ladies.
Time in.
Yeah. Two yelling that perhaps Thilbresh might have blown up a little earlier in the previous indiscretion. So here we go then. Phillips again finding Taylor. Good communication between hooker and jumper. Lovely handoff there. Wales full of running. Robin Wilkins again taking Wales up to the Italian 10-meter line. Snowsill thinks perhaps about the kick. Bringing in Kerin Lake from the Ospreys. Back in the ranks, crossed twice in the 39-0 warm-up match against Spain last month. Wales looking to create an overlap here.
Time off.
No, man.
Drop the ball, please.
What's happened this time?
Red, can you take a step? Blue, take a step. T-M-O, yes, Neil.
Well, Neil Patterson from Scotland is the television match official. We'll have a look at
okay, thank
something.
You.
Has there been foul play is the question. And if so, who was the perpetrator?
Can you hear him?
The assistant referee, JD, Jungile Jadisveni, stepped in from the far side.
Perfect.
To have a word with Loserbrecht. So we wait for Neil Patterson's decision. Elinor Snowsill from the Bristol Ladies.
Okay, I'll have a word.
Gwent Dragons.
Yeah, captain.
Region.
Captain, captain.
So both captains called. All right, we'll listen
just on
in.
The 15 here, Neil, is that good? Perfect. So just at that last breakdown, we had a neck roll by a red player. Be very careful. Yeah. It's going to be a penalty here for blue.
Okay.
So you might have heard it was a neck roll by one of the Welsh players.
So time is in. Over here.
So grabbing a player by the neck and trying to move the
dangerous
Italian player
play.
Away from the tackle area to release the ball. And that's illegal and dangerous. It's the Italian penalty, which doesn't find touch. Runs through Ellen Evans. Go to ground. Midway through between the 22 and 10 metre line, Caryl Thomas. And sets it up nicely for Kira Bevan. Snowsill outside her 22. Kicks long. Solari. And she has got Manuela Furlan with her. A little too ambitious on that occasion, perhaps. It's still there, though. For the Italian forwards to take it up. That would have been the loose head prop, Elisa Cucchiella.
Off red first, then off blue.
Unfortunate for Wales.
Scrum.
Came off a Welsh hand,
off
so it'd be
first.
An Italian scrum.
Let's take it over here. It's blue ball.
Azure produced their best ever finish of third in 2015.
Not forward off of red.
Doing a wealth of experience, no less than 11 returning from that Welsh defeat of 2016.
Quotes. Forward. Bind.
And Bettoni in the front row.
Set.
Trevisan. Locatelli.
Nice cut.
And all players behind the scrum. Bar Manuela Furlan. So here we have a look now then at that incident. Look for the neck roll from a Welsh player. It was the Welsh captain penalised?
Coach. Bind. Set.
We've seen some powerful drives on the Welsh 8 in the opening 40 minutes. They've done well to get the ball away. Zangirolami to Furlan. This is Sofia Stefan. Can play on the wing or at scrum half. Italian supporters again in fine voice.
Leave it, leave it.
12 minutes into the second half. In midfield, that's Chiagai, the tight head, Rigoni. Well placed kick. Covered though by Taverner.
Brought in.
Rebecca Rowe waits, and she's got support from three or four forwards. Right on the 22, was that carried back in? Well, says referee Lebrecht, good work by Snowsill. In danger of becoming isolated here. In goes the Italian number 14, Silari, to get her hands on the ball. But Wales have secured it.
Bevan.
Well, she had to take the initiative herself there. No one offering herself to take the kick in a better position. Snowsill evades the first and second tackle. Full of running.
You guys can stand here, okay?
Seems to be a breakdown in communication in the Welsh ranks on that occasion. We need to sort that out. Just the one score separating the teams, and we saw in the first half how the Italians built up momentum.
Sorry.
To get that crucial try before the break.
Also, I just need to keep the gaps to make sure, yeah, so. Just hold the, yeah, thanks.
Dyddgu Hywel is the player injured. The Wales fullback. In the opposite number, Manuela Furlan is poised to enter the line outside Maria Cioffi.
I'm okay. Okay, I will. Time's still off. Just hold,
so
hold.
At that stage in the game where you can expect to see some substitutions made.
Yeah, so I just got the call for the neck roll. It was on number two, okay, so just be very careful.
Right angle. Looks to run off that injury.
Time in.
She's in the shadow of her own posts as Italy prepare to take this lineup through Melissa Bettoni. Challenge from Wales, but it's on its way. In from the right wing comes Michela Silari. Isabella Locatelli in support. The open side front forward. They're screaming for the ball out on the right. Rigoni on lovely play here. And again, it's the fullback looking to get her second score into the hands of Sofia Stefan. Held up 2-3 meters short. And the ball lost forward, I think. The indication from Rosa Lebrecht. And Manuela Furlan. Not happy at all, captain. Sara Baratin barking the odds here. Now as Wales do make a change, off comes Kira Bevan, and in her place will be Sean Moore, the replacement wearing number 21 from the Newport Gwent Dragons region, winning her 10th cap.
Time in.
So her first duty will be to feed into the scrum.
Coach.
5 meters out from her own try line.
Set.
Wales can expect the drive to come through from the loose set. Powell Hughes powering away once again, puffing the cheeks. Snowsill. Lovely work by the outside half to Dyddgu Hywel. Left footed, into touch, clears her lines. Good work by Wales. Under pressure. Under pressure at the scrum. But look at this effort from Shona Powell Hughes. 38 caps today for the Wales number 8. She started a block against Italy 12 months ago. In the corresponding encounter at the Talbot Athletic ground in Aberavon. Taken out of the air there by the Italian number 5, Alice Trevisan. This is the Nagati hooker, Melissa Bettoni.
Leave it.
Roland Phillips was telling me only this morning that Wales needed to keep an eye out for her. Was she? Really no. Does galvanize the forward effort. Penalty to Italy.
Second goal, leave it, 9. Got the ball.
Oh, Sean Moore.
Have a word with number 13.
Having a go there.
Just hold.
Yeah.
Correct form, second go.
Also in the thick of it, so Rigoni. It's a well-placed kick. And Wales know what to expect here. No quarter asked and no quarter given. The feisty Italian captain, Sara Berrettin. And can he make the Welsh centre at loggerheads there? Giordano once again with Wales sack the maul, and absolutely delighted with that effort. Applauding the effort there was Caryl Thomas, the Wales loose head. They have to stop that driving ball before it gains forward momentum. Exasperation there on the face of the Italian captain, Sara Berrettin.
To your left, sir.
Yep.
It's a crucial moment in the game here. 17 minutes into the second half. Wales leading by 15 points to 8. Just the one score. Converted try. Italy looking to apply the pressure at the scrum, but Wales hold firm. Powell Hughes again picks up at the base of the scrum, goes onto the narrow side, sets it up. Won't go into the hands of Snowsill this time, but she stands back 5 metres out from her own try line. Once more, though, it's the forwards who will take it up to Charlotte Harris. She's held up, is she? Well stolen. Well, should have gone back into the hands of the outside half earlier. Because it's advantage Italy here again. And it's claimed by the number four, the fearsome looking Flavia Severin, the boxer.
Just hold, guys, we'll wait for the shoelace.
Trevisan. Wasn't in the initial squad. When it was announced.
Time is in.
35 caps today. Tallest member of that Italian forward unit at 5 feet 11 inches tall. That's 1 meters 80.
No, one.
Rigoni to Zangirolami. Wales scurrying back in defence. Rigoni, the kick over the top. Howell is there, calls for the mark. And that's a let off.
It's on you.
Everyone telling Dyddgu Hywel what she should be doing here. I think she knows full well. Back to the hands of Snowsill. Who gets it away. Almost up to the Wales 10 meter line. The crowd really enjoying this one. Yes. The people of Yesi who come out.
Perfect, thanks.
In goodly numbers to support these ladies. I have to say, a fair contingent of Welsh supporters here as well, family and friends.
Thank you.
They made the long journey out to the Adriatic coast. It's not an Adriatic summer, that's for sure. It's a little breezy. Palm down on the Welsh side. Good work at the back of the line out. Moore looks for it. There it is. To Sonnet Harris. And regular on the Sens circuit as well is Harris. The bounce is kind this time for Robin Wilkins. He pushes that little kick through and keeps the ball in play. Terrific work there by the Welsh centre. There she is again alongside her colleague in midfield, Kerin Lake. Italy somehow have managed to secure possession.
Come on.
A lot of shouting, a lot of talking. And the hands grabbed around the neck. And Wales have done enough to warrant the scrum here. That's good work and applauded by the replacements on the bench. Will surely come on in this last quarter. Yeah. Roland Phillips, great atmosphere engendered by the Wales coach. feel that around the hotel last evening and this morning.
Good idea.
Welsh ladies really up for this one, their first match. Of course, the big win for them next weekend against England at Cardiff Arms Park. Amy Evans on the tight head. Against Elisa Kukiela.
Both hitting down here. Any better body position from both of you, okay? So just.
Amy Evans, interesting fact about her. Amy is that she is a diabetic, but she's trialing a new glucose sensor. Glucose sensor technology this season to enable her to train and play at peak fitness. Tremendous news for her. She's proving her worth on the tight end there.
Wheel.
Italy deliberately wheeling that scrum around, much to the disgust of the Italian supporters. That decision from referee Lebrecht. The next score could well be decisive. Snowsill having a word with her outside backs there, telling them what she requires of them. First element is the line out. She has been expertly executed between Caris Phillips and Rachel Taylor, and there it is again. To good effect, Shona Powell here, who's on the angle. Brought down 5 metres short. Wales are there in numbers.
John
Rowe commanding her players. Stand back. Let me get the ball out to Caris Phillips, she says. 5 metres short, the Wales captain. Pull down more. Back to Snowsill once again, this time to Kerin Lake. And Italy there in numbers. As Moore somehow gets the ball away, only as far as Rachel Taylor. Can't get her pass away, so she goes to ground, sets it up again. It'll come out on the narrow side to Amy Evans. No silky passes from her into the Italian 22. A lobbed pass into midfield. Rebecca Rowe takes it up for Wales. Italy once again proving their worth in defence. As Seanad Harris receives the ball in midfield, offloads to Powell Hughes. Great combination there along with Rachel Taylor in the back row for Wales. The pass into no man's land from Ellie Snowsill, giving chases Silari for Italy. And Wales going backwards here. But they've recovered. Taylor on her shoulder, the other present, Rebecca Rowe and Powell Hughes. Thomas spins. Snowsill kick over the top. Not a bad effort. Furlan can't take it. It's a mix-up between Furlan and Silari. And it's still advantage Wales. And this is where it all started for them a couple of minutes ago. But full marks to the Italian women for their defensive effort. A mix-up there between the two very experienced players. Manuela Furlan, 51 caps today. Michela Silari, 30 caps.
So, we'll keep a look.
Valuable experience.
Thank you.
It's 5 wins apiece in the Six Nations competition. Can we get the water for off, Wales
please?
And Italy since
time in, water off,
the inaugural
please.
Tournament in 2007. Games between the two nations, that is. So who will break the deadlock, I wonder? 15 minutes to the final whistle. Italy 8, Wales 15, as Rachel Taylor climbs high once again. The forwards are there in numbers, again driving her forward. Look at that expression on her face, all the effort. And will it prove fruitful, I wonder? Caris Phillips, the captain, breaks loose and gets the try. And that is a crucial score for Wales. Expertly done. So it all started with Phillips throwing into the line out. Taylor, not for the first time, securing possession at the back of the line out. And there she is, pumping the legs backwards towards that Italian try line, guiding her forwards. And there they are in numbers, right at the back.
Sorry,
is Caryl Phillips, the captain. And she breaks clear on the narrow side.
So the TML reviewed it, there was no issue.
The Italian second row forward, this time had a back to Phillips. And it's a great score for Wales, which takes them 12 points clear with a conversion to come. Snowsill. Snowsill. And she pushed that one, wide for the far upright.
Yep.
And Wales are two scores to the good.
Time off.
Italy looking to make a substitution here. We want to bring on Marta Ferrari, and you can tell that this is a popular substitution on for Lucia Gai.
Number four, red.
Wales also want to make a substitution
here.
It'll be Rebecca Rowe who's being substituted.
Number six, red.
Siwan Lillicrap and Ali Butcher's coming on, wearing 20.
Happy.
So it's 19-6 for Seanette Harris. Fresh legs, they're on for Wales.
No.
In the back row. And in the second row as well. So Italy have a lot of work to do in the final 13 minutes. Snowsill kicks long downfield. The bounce into the hands of Manuela Furlan. A dangerous, potent attacking runner from fullback. That try at the end of the first half came close a few minutes ago.
Move, Red!
Wales throwing everything into this defensive effort.
Get out, Red!
Being penalised.
15, left roll. You have to roll. Over there.
See how well guilty of not rolling away. Here's Rigoni. Is the far touchline. The temperatures have
blue line. Yeah, you're good there. Perfect.
And a degree or four here at the Stadio Comunale in the last few minutes. But from a Welsh perspective, well, the heat is certainly on. 20-8. Mel Clay looks or prepares to challenge. Clean take of the line, not the best of passes. Wales up very quickly, Snowsill with the tackle on Zangirolami. Silari from left wing, Furlan. Italy don't have a fullback at the moment if Wales can get their hands on the ball, but it's there for the industrious Italian hooker, Melissa Bettoni. Rigoni once again looking to get the pass away. But the path was blocked by the Wales replacement, Sean Moore, at scrum half. Advantage Italy. Wales offside. There goes the Italian captain. Great run, sniping run up to the Wales 22, and Italy are not done yet. Severin. The lanky lock forward has done some sterling work this afternoon for Italy, has Flavia Severin. And again, the crowd showing their support in fine voice. Cookie
out.
Wales up quickly in defence, 2-on-1. Could be a gap out wide. Italy can work the ball out quickly, straight down the middle, and goes. Well, have been Trevisan. They've called for it on this side of the field. Zangirolami back to strength. In she goes, sets it up again. It's a prop forward out in midfield here. Wales desperately defending their try line as Italy look to strike back. And it's Ferrari pulled down 5 metres short. Rigoni tackled by her opposite number, Snowsill. And Italy again will get the penalty. And Rose Lebrecht was looking for advantage to Italy in any event. The offence was a little before that. So Italy want to run it. Berrettini leaves it for Severin. But again, she runs high into the tackle. As Taylor gets her hands on the ball, the Wales number 7. And Wales have done enough to thwart that effort from the Italian women. As the Italians protest.
You have less than 7.
That perhaps Sue and Lillicrap was in an offside position or interfering with play on the floor. Lillicrap wearing 19 for Wales. Replacement. From the Swansea and Ospreys clubs, just winning a 6th cap today.
Forward on the side. No, bring it up, guys.
Huge
bring it up.
Effort.
Sorry. We're on an angle
called
here.
For here by
I need
Wales.
You to be straight, okay? Not on an angle. So come up on this side.
Thomas against Ferrari.
One hit. Crouch. Bind.
Ferrari can play at second row or at a prop forward. Wales under pressure. On their own try line, playing high-risk rugby here. Need players to
back off red.
Not as pillars on either side of the ruck, and the kick charged down. And Wales desperately wanted to clear their lines with 7 minutes or so remaining. Italy desperately wanting a converted try to bring them right back into this game. But Wales have it, and they are moving forward. This time, surely it'll go back in the hands of Snowsill. Almost back on the on the dead ball line. Oh, he's taking it up again. Sean Moore doesn't find touch. And here come the Italians through Furlan. Forward from Zangirolami, right in the face of Wales centre Robin Wilkins. And gives us some
number
stick.
11 red. 11 red.
So Wales want to make a substitution here. Eddie Taverner departs. And on comes Jess Kavanagh-Williams for her first cap. Scored one of Wales' 7 tries in the friendly 39 points to nil defeat
just
of Spain.
Sure
it's a proud moment for her
shorts,
and another member
jersey.
Of the Carnarvon Rugby Club. They'll be delighted for her.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. That's for sure. Jessica Kavanagh-Williams and is on for AD Taverner on the left wing. Under 7 minutes to go. The clock restarts.
Set.
Sean Moore prepares to feed the scrum on the Welsh 22 centre field. Powerful drive coming from the powerful Marta Ferrari. The Wales have done well to set it up. Wilkins is there, acting and standing scrum half. Back to Dyddgu Hywel, left footed into the wind. It's safely into touch. So it's looking good for Wales at the moment. Could be a rare win away from home. That was the kick charged down by Rigoni, the Italian outside half.
Time off.
The Italians coming into this match.
Sorry, are we having a substitution?
The benefit of warm-up matches. With those 4 warm-up matches for Wales, 2 at the end of 2016 and 2
okay.
again.
Okay, time in.
Upping the tempo.
guys, the new year over here.
Against Spain and Ireland have certainly done them a power of good.
Let's go then. Take a bit more of a big step, please, guys. Open it up.
First win over Italy in 4 years. Ben Bento, back in 2013, 16-15 the score that day. Clear daylight between the teams with just over 5 minutes remaining. 12 points the difference. Comes forward from the Welsh hand. So Italy will get the put in at the scrum. The crowd is silent once again. Taylor at the back.
13, yep.
Palm down by her. It was Phillips, the Wales captain, who nudged it forward. More replacements than for Wales. Off goes the tight head.
Four
Amy
blue.
Evans.
Four blue.
Keris Hale comes on for her fourth cap. Member of the 2014 World Cup squad for Wales.
Time in.
Confian Pierce is on to win her first cap. Would you believe it? Yes, another representative from the Carnarvon club. It's a proud moment for the Pierce family, no doubt. One of 10 children is Gwynfian Pierce.
Let's go.
Five brothers, four sisters.
Set.
And farming stock from good farming stock in the Conwy Valley.
Early.
Beautiful part of the world. So Italy come again looking for a score which will bring them back into this game and give them hope. With less than 5 minutes to go, Rigoni into the hands there of Giordano, the Italian number 8. Good recycling. This time Zangirolami holds on to the pass. Italy are here in numbers on the narrow side. Nudge forward surely by the number 11, Sofia Stefan. And a scratch of the head from the Italian captain, Sara Baratin. Made a try and scored a try against Wales in Padua 2 years ago, did the Italian captain.
Just over four minutes.
About an hour north of Yesi.
4 minutes of hard work, please.
4 minutes of hard work, you might have heard over the referee's microphone.
Bind.
In a strong Welsh accent.
Set.
More feeds. The Welsh scrum holds firm as Shona Powell Hughes brings it away. Runs straight at Beatrice Rigoni. This is Phillips, the captain. She's led her troops well today. And she'll be absolutely delighted if the score remains as it is for another 3 or 4 minutes. But they have to be wary of Manuela Furlan. If Italy are going to get a score from somewhere, it's more likely than not to come from the Italian fullback. It's the best of passes there from Melissa Bettoni. But Italy have retained possession. Waiting in midfield, that's Alice Trevisan.
Leave it, Red.
Dug out by the captain, Rigoni. Zangirolami sends Sofia Stefan up centre field, in from the wing. Again, it's there, lovely back pass there from Rigoni to Furlan, giving chase, but back there.
22.
To save the day is Ellen Evans. No lack of speed in the Evans family. If you're supporters of the World Rally Championship, well, the young Welshman Elvin Evans is Ellen Evans' cousin.
About two minutes, the World Rally car this year,
back where he should be. Battling with the best in the world, and here is Ellen Evans' cousin, doing sterling work for the Wales ladies.
Time off. We have a sub.
Massively organized.
Number one, Red.
So Wales again.
Number one, Red.
Just taking the sting out of that, Italian momentum.
Number two, Red. Who will be the captain?
Seven.
Okay. No.
I thought it was a little premature earlier on. Wasn't it when the person came on? Now she's on.
Your captain just said that you're going to assume those duties.
But everything I said about her a few minutes ago still holds true.
Okay, are we good?
It's a proud day for her. That's
time
for sure.
And make sure you're behind.
Much of her. She's pretty elusive. Baratin. The clock is against Italy as Maria Cioffi takes the ball above her head. Italy will get the penalty. It's asking a lot of them to score.
Be very careful.
13 points in the minute and a half or so. Wales are destined
for a
win in their opening match of the 2017 Six Nations Championship. It's been a hard-fought victory. It looked so close, didn't it, at half-time as Italy came back in the final 10, 15 minutes of the first half.
Okay, perfect.
A try from Caris Phillips, the Wales captain, following a concerted drive from the Wales forward eight. Has opened a healthy gap between the teams. Into the final minute, Italy 8, Wales 20 here at the Stadio Comunale in Jesi. As Rigoni pops it up to Sofia Stefan. Wales again pressed into defensive duties. Big hit coming in there. Harris with a tackle. Zangirolami has tried a level best this afternoon, as has Sofia Stefan. And here comes the number 7. Headed off for the pass, though, by Dyddgu Hywel. And there it is. Referee Lebrecht calls time. Handshakes all round. And Wales have claimed a rare victory away from home here in Italy against a very strong and resilient Italian side.
You had lose the...
Is it?
They claimed the early score, which was all important, through Caryl Thomas, the loose head prop. They went in at the break with a slender 2-point advantage, but came out all guns blazing in the second half to silence the Italian crowd. And it's finished here at the Stadio Comunale, IAC, Italy 8, Wales 20.